Hello and welcome to one of the first Maraki by Laurie macrame tutorials. So in this video I really hope to teach you guys how to make macrame feathers. So macrame feathers are fab addition to any wall. You can hang them over doors, you can hang them on windowsills, add them onto a bookmark, put a keyring on them, add it onto your bag, and what's even better is you only need a tiny little bit of scrap thread. Right, so before I begin I just want to say I hope you guys are all staying safe during this lockdown period, keeping your minds busy. It'd be fab to help you guys dabble a little bit in your creativity and getting, you know, keeping those minds busy, I think is the key. But just want to say that just flow with your creative spirit, whatever you do. Creativity is all about experimenting, making mistakes. I think that's the key thing in macrame, is each little mistake you make makes every piece unique, and that's what I love about it. Every little thing you make is different. So, let's do it. Before you begin, you will need to cut 20 centimetres of thread. So this is a whole 20 centimetre piece, and then you'll need to do that 20 times to give us an average sized feather. Also, you'll need to cut a 50 centimetre piece of thread as well, and this will act as the stem in the middle of your feather. So this will be what we are working around. So I'm using a cork board with a pin. This is just a technique I've always used since day one. However, at the end of this video, I will show you how to attach your feathers onto a piece of driftwood or any other item you'd like. So we're going to begin by meeting the two ends of our long 50 centimeter piece of string. Find the further end and loop this around your pin. Now you're going to take two of your 20 centimeter threads, and this is when we're going to learn some knots. So to start with, take one of the lengths, meet the two ends, and then we're going to be working with this loop, okay? So you've done one, do the same with the other, meet the two ends, turn it around, and there's your loop. So we've got two loops. What we're going to do, using our stem of the feather, the working cord, we're going to pass one loop underneath, okay? So you've passed your 20 centimetre underneath the 50 centimetre, okay? Take your other loop, pass it underneath and up through, over the top, okay? So you can see I've gone underneath and over the top of the 50 centimetre. Then with the straggly bits of your first cord, these are then going to be passed up through your second cord, okay? So you've got the first one going underneath and then the second one going over the top. Now all we're going to do is pull these tight, and that's it. Slide it up to the top, not too far because you still want to get it. You still want to work with this a little bit. And that's it, you've got your first knot. All right, so you can see that. So I'll do it one more time for you. So two ends, make them meet. By making your ends meet, this will just make the feather more even at the end. But we will still need to trim our feather to make it look nice and fluffy. So another two ends, little loop. Okay, first cord, second cord, put this down. First cord goes underneath. Second cord goes through your first cord. It goes over the top. It goes over the top of the 50 centimeter cord, the stem. And then your straggly bits, technical terms, your straggly bits will go up through the loop of your second, okay? And again, pull tight. And that says. So what we're going to do is we're going to repeat this process 10 times until we've used up all of our threads. So I'll just speed this up for you guys. Ta-da! That should be you. One more, and that'll do us. So that's me use up all my 10 cords. Oops. Just make sure when you do pull up your feather parts, that you are keeping that stem piece nice and tight. So you don't want to twist them over. By that I mean crossing the two over and then twisting them up, because you'll end up with like a spiral feather. It wouldn't sit nice and flat against your wall. It'll start to kind of curve. So if you do want to make one of the maxi feathers, like the huge big ones, you would just continue this as long as you'd want your feather to be. But this is just going to be like a nice little average size of the hand feather. So this part, the next part, is when I start to feel a bit like a hairdresser, when it comes to trimming and feathering out your feathers. This is what gives it that fluffy effect. So what you want to do, this way, I'm right-handed, hold the other side of your feather and then just brush it out. So you're going to start just brushing it down. I'm just using a hairbrush that I keep only for macrame, but it's just your average hairbrush. And you just brush these out until all the fibres start to separate from each other. So you can see, try and get as close to the stem as possible, but be careful not to snag your knots and pull them out. So you want to do this the whole way around. And don't forget about your little stem part as well, that needs brushed out too. Don't know if you can see, but I'm working on the world's smallest table, leaving my phone in a box. Really hard to do that brushing out, but all good, we got there. Okay, so now you have this rough feather shape. So I've got my loop over my pin, got my rough feather shape, can speak. And you can see the stem is a little bit longer than the rest. So the first step we're gonna do is we're just gonna cut that so it's the same length, move my phone here, same length as the rest of it. That's us. So we're gonna take a scissors and we're gonna cut a rough outline of our feather. Okay, so it doesn't need to be perfect, so we are gonna go back and trim it up. So if you think about this kind of shape, just roughly, we'll go back and perfect it later on. So when I'm cutting my feathers, I always like to start from the top because that's where the fibres are going. If you do start cutting from the bottom, it leads to an overall jaggy edge. So you better start from the top, just makes it easier later on. So if you want, you can take it off the loop for this, because I like to just set it on the palm of my hand, because your palm of your hand's got a natural curve. Please be careful not to cut yourself doing this, alright? So I'm just gonna... time to buy myself new scissors as well. Just cutting round the edge. So we've now got that rough feather shape. I'm going to turn it this way so you can see it a little bit better. Just again, take your brush back to it, brush those fibres out, and this is when you start to see a little bit of a kind of scraggy edge. But that's alright, we're going to fix it. Pull that down. Oh, that's what I mean. Be careful not to snag your knots. Here we go. Okay, so now we've got a rough feather shape, but you can see it is a little bit scraggy. So now all you're going to do, you've got your rough shape, you're just going to take your scissors again and really sharpen off that edge. Get a nice sharp feeling. So now you've done that, again, just repeat the process. Just brush and trim until you are satisfied with your feather. And that's it. You have your feather all ready to go, nice and fluffy. I'm just going to leave it at that, because if I keep brushing and trimming, I'll be here all day. Ta-da! That should be you. So you've got a nice feather there to hang anywhere at all. So you can hang them on the door, like that. And if you do want to attach it onto a stick, what you want to do is make sure that the loop that you start with, therefore remember the 50 centimeter thread, before you add any of your knots on, you want to do this little knot. So take your stick, take your thread, wrap the thread over, under, grab those threads, pull them through. So it's called a lark's head knot. Just tighten that right up and that's you, ready to go. And then you would just do these knots either side, and this is your new stem. The difference is it's hung on a bit of wood. All right. And then...
Well, I hope you enjoy the first macrame tutorial by Meraki Vai Laurie. I'm hoping to do these more frequently, especially during lockdown, to keep, again, to keep your minds busy, keep your creative flow flowing. But yeah, enjoy the rest of your Friday night. Have a good weekend. See you later.